All right.
Where are we at?
In Portland?
Yeah. This dude asked his dad if he could come to the junkyard with me. And his dad said yes, but he didn't even... And he called me and he said, yeah, dude, my dad said I could go. And we came to the junkyard, but then on the way here, he's all like, dude, I thought we were going to Bend. I told my dad we were going to go to the junkyard, but I didn't tell him we were going to Portland. So, in other words, he's out of his comfort zone, right? We are here to get that engine for that guy, that D16, either a Y7 or a Y8 block. If it's a complete engine, we're going to get a Y8. And if it's not complete, we're going to get a Y7, just the bottom ends. They're the same. How old are you? 16? He doesn't even supposed to be in here. But he has a mustache. Huh? He has a mustache and he looks older than what he is. So they let him in. He's supposed to be 18. And they didn't even ask him anything. So he just pretty much sneaked him in here. Seen better days. Oh, never mind. Dude, you can literally see through. Oh, look, a coupe. You guys need the door handle, remember? Well, it's gone, so.
Out of luck.
Out of luck. Sometimes they leave them in here, but. Came across some goodies. One goodie is a TSX. Yeah, K28 too. But they already removed one of the cams, so I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna take it. They already removed one of the cams and then came across this, but it's already gone. This is a CRV. It was manual, all-wheel drive, but the transmission is already gone. Look, so that means it wasn't wrecked because they cut the front end. Eighty-one twenty-eight. Transmission's original. Engine is not. You can see it's a junkyard engine. You can see the letters. You can see it's never been overheated. It's actually GNR. I know where GNR is. So all the spark plugs are in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and probably start working on this one. I'm gonna pull everything out, tip the engine over, make sure all the rods are there, and I'm gonna end up taking just the bottom end. I don't think it's gonna get any better than that. You can see it didn't get hot, and we just want to know how the oil is, and then the oil's clean. Look at that. Let's see if I can focus. Yeah, the oil looks clean. So I'm gonna tip over the engine and pull the oil pan out, and then we'll go from there and we can start taking everything off. And also came across an H2284 automatic. Someone was hating. People that come into these junkyards, I don't know why they do that, but you see what they did? Someone took the cylinder head and then they just smashed it, man. They just broke the block, yeah. That's not cool. Look at that. You can see where they hammered it. That's why we can't have nothing. I mean, I didn't need it, but still, somebody might have. Okay, I think it's gonna be that one. Let's go walk around one more time, or finish walking the yard, and then we're probably gonna come to this one. This one looks more promising, and it's already off too.
Give me a second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she is waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar.
If you guys don't know, these Suzuki's all-wheel drives SX4s, these things come with a viscous. A lot of people on the all-wheel drives are, you know, searching and looking for different ways to all-wheel drive their cars. This thing has a little viscous right there. I'm not gonna take it, but just let you guys know. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, it would be cool to take it and just prototype it, try it out. Another coupe. This one was a nice color too, the door handle. C6. Man, look at that engine. It looks clean. Alternator's brand new. We took the injectors. Oh, look, the spacers that we need, remember?
What was Zin's agent say? Zin's agent said that he needed.
We didn't bring any vice grips, otherwise we would remove these so we can use those too. Take that out, and that's the washer that we need, remember?
This?
And then, oh, you weren't there, but yeah, we need this washer. Well, we don't need it right now, but I'm saying we needed it.
Oh yeah. So, well, that's the one that you said that was like a plug.
Yeah, on the normal ones it's, yeah, like a plug. Oh, one thing you guys do need, I used it from Darren's car. Darren's gonna find out, so before he finds out, we need the fuel pump hanger. We need this, the hanger, not the fuel pump, just the hanger. So we can take this, throw it in the wheelbarrow right now, but just leave it there. But before we pay, yeah, I'll take it off over there. Another one, dude, and the door handle is missing. Jeez. Huh? Everybody needs that handle, huh? Dang it. Everyone needs this handle. These dudes need that handle. The handle's gone. I think they need this too. Where is it at? This. They need this. You guys need this.
Need this?
Yeah. Not this one. This is for the defroster, but that's for the lights. It goes right here. You guys need that. This was a nice, good taken care of hatchback, and somebody just decided to trash it. Like, you know how hard it is to find EG hatches that are not rusted. The glass, the rear glass is still here. Look for it, because you might find it. You never know. Sometimes they just toss them in here.
What?
The door handle. Man, that's sad. See this thing out here. These things are so hard to come by. It's a lot of good parts on it. A D15B8. Corner light. Pretty sure they need this corner light, but they're pretty expanded here. And this thing had AC too. No keys. 315. This one's been here for a while. No, you didn't find it? Wait, what? Someone scored on that transmission. Transmission's gone. It was a manual too. That sucks. I would have taken that too. But.
I know you're trying to forget, but between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
This block looks good. That block looks good. We're gonna spin it and then we're gonna find out right now if it's good. We'll pull the oil pan and we might take that one. This is the last row of imports. It's automatic. We're gonna check out this one and then we're gonna find out if it's good. We'll get to work. I'll let you guys know what we end up doing. I'm gonna pull this oil pan out and then we're gonna check it out because it looks in decent shape. You can see the engine looks clean. All right, so we pull the oil pan out and I don't even have to turn the engine. I can already tell it's just an oil pan. Yes, I don't know if you guys can catch it, but this rod looks fine. That rod looks okay. That rod looks fine. That rod looks dark. Phone can't really catch it, but you can see that rod, how dark it looks. And that rod looks okay. But with that being said, I pull the oil pan out. Check this out, Tommy. You see all that copper flakes, especially those. Yeah, those are signs of a rod destroyed itself, chewed up itself. So with that being said, we are not taking this. You can see there's a lot more pieces down there. Not a lot. You see them? There's big ones in there, look. So yeah, this one's a bust. That's probably why it's here. Had a rod knock, didn't fix it. Someone took the cylinder head. So, let's pick up the tools and we're gonna go back to that other one. Okay, now grab the 10 with an extension. You can use this one. And we're gonna take all of these out. Set the world on fire. We can burn. there isn't. There's just silicone pieces. And silicone pieces, but that's it. There's no metal, no flakes, no nothing. Oil looks good. What is this? Yeah, it's silicone. It's not metal. It's just silicone. Good. That one looks good. That one looks good. That one looks good. That one looks good. Overall, the block looks good. So I'm going to take this block and start taking all this off. Pull that head off and let's go home. So we're going to do that. Put you guys on the time lapse. They're supposed to be right here?
Yeah, they don't have any other ones to go right here?
They're right there, they're in the bottom.
Oh, that's that?
Yeah, when the engine turns, the pistons go up and down. We had to remove the cylinder head because they consider it as a long block and they say they don't have prices for short blocks. So if I leave the head, I went and I asked, good thing I went and I asked first. And he says, if the head is off, I can sell it to you, but without a warranty, no returns. But if the head is on there, he says, I have to sell it to you as a complete block, complete motor from oil pan to valve cover. They wanted $440 for oil pan to valve cover. And I told them, no, that somebody already removed the cylinder head. Like you guys saw, the one that was bad, it was already missing the cylinder head. So I told them it was already missing the cylinder head, which it wasn't. I told Tommy to wait for me over here. And he says, if you have the short block and you think it's good for you and you're not going to return it, I'll give it to you for $230-something with, if you have the core, which I do. So that's almost half the price. So we're going to be in it like $300 with fuel and everything. And yeah, to me, it's still worth it. Some people get mad because, oh, you got them too cheap. Yeah, but nobody else is going to do it for you right away. I had to call into work and whatnot to come and do it, and that's why the car sat for the longest time at the other shop, because they couldn't find the engine. So yeah, so that's gonna be it. We're gonna wrap it up. Unfortunately, it's a good cylinder head. It's gonna stay here and nobody buys these Y7 heads, so we're gonna take that and go home. Well, stop and eat, right, Tommy?